Hello everyone, and welcome or welcome back to my channel. I got my haircut last night, chopped a lot of it off, and have some bangs going on. I'm not in love with the bangs. They're still like really kind of poofy and a little bit shorter than I had originally imagined. But the nice thing about hair is that it grows and they'll grow out, and maybe I'll be a little bit happier with them once they're a little bit longer. But yeah, it is Friday. I cleaned the house this morning. The house is feeling really nice and clean. But now I'm gonna do something kind of fun. We started renovating Rosie's room just after she was born. I painted it and we kind of have her set up in there right now. But there's a lot of furniture in there because we still have our double bed in there because it's serving as our spare room when people come over. We just moved the baby into our room. But Clara has been asking for a big bed for a little while now. She keeps wanting to sleep in the big bed. So I am going to move the double bed into Clara's room today. We'll put the toddler bed in Rosie's room so that if we do have guests over, the guests can stay in Clara's room and Clara can easily just sleep in Rosie's room in the toddler bed. Giving Rosie a official kind of like nursery, because right now it's just full of so much furniture. So I'll be so happy to like officially have her room done and like show you that. And Clara will have a big bed to sleep in. She'll be so excited and so happy to see it. So I'm kind of excited for her reaction when she sees it. But let's go upstairs. So here is Clara's room before with the toddler bed and her little reading corner. I was vacuuming in here, and I will continue vacuuming once we move the bed. I will show you Rosie's room next. We just gotta wake her up from her nap first. Rosie! Hi, Rosie! So this is what Rosie's room looks like right now. There is a lot of furniture in here. And we basically just use the crib and the chair back there. So we will get the bed out, and I bought this little nightstand and built it for her. She has a name sign just like Clara does, and we have new curtains to hang up. So maybe that stuff will get hung up this weekend, and we can actually get a nice room going on for you. Do you want your room to be nice? Yeah. All right, here is our finished product. I think she's going to love it. I didn't put the frame in the bottom of the bed because I think it would be too tall for her to get up on and off easily. I think she's gonna be so excited to see it. I wasn't able to finish Rosie's room. She was getting very upset with me that she didn't want to lay on the ground anymore. And I took her downstairs so I could have some lunch and she could jump at the jolly jumper, and she pooped everywhere. So I had a little bit of a disaster to clean up, but I'll kind of give you the update on her room after. I'm not happy with how it is. It's hard to find placement with the window and the vent and everything like that. So I'll see if I can figure something out and keep playing with it. Luckily, her furniture is fairly light in that room and it's easy to move around. So I can keep moving it around until I find an arrangement that I actually like. Right, Clara is home now. We're gonna show her her room for the first time. So I'm gonna record her reaction to it when she walks in.
Go look at your room.
Here, Daddy.
I don't want that.
Okay, you just put it on the ground.
Here.
Thank you. Wow, Clara, what is this? Are you gonna sleep in that tonight?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Where's
your pillow? It's over there. We'll get it out after.
I can't see it. Oh, I see it.
Okay, no, no, no.
Yeah.
Hello, it is Monday morning this morning. Didn't really get any vlogging done this weekend just because we had some family things going on. And yesterday the weather was pretty terrible. We got like a big snow squall and lots of snow, so we just kind of stayed inside. It was so windy and cold out, and it's even like really cold out this morning too. I think it's like feels like minus 24 with wind chill. It's not nice. I just got Rosie up from her nap, and she's looking pretty cute in her big fluffy sweater and her jeans. Can you say hi? Ow, like oh my hair. Hi. She's got some really, really fluffy hair. Oh, and I meant to say something. Look, can you show everyone? You see, I got two TVs. Anyways, so that's my little Rosie update for you. Yeah, so we're just kind of staying home today. It's nice and sunny out, but it is very cold. Just trying to get some things done. I vacuumed this morning because everyone was home on the weekend, so it got a little dirty. And edited and uploaded a video, so I'm trying to get back into it. It has been really hard to get back into vlogging after Vlogmas. It's just a lot of vlogs all at once. And I just really needed the break. So yeah, we are going to hopefully sort out some of the clothes in the girls' rooms because Rosie is too big for some of her clothes and Clara is too big for some of her clothes, so we just need to go through all that. And I'm not really sure what else I'm going to do today. It's kind of a relaxing Monday in a way. Good morning, everyone. It is the next day. Rosie's down for a nap right now. So I am actually making some baby food for her. Currently just boiling up some carrots. I will puree them and then I'm just gonna mix them with some breast milk. I've managed to freeze a good stash of them. So we have like slowly started some solids. She's almost 5 months old. Our doctor did recommend waiting until 6, but she's definitely showing some signs of readiness, like trying to grab food and put it in her mouth. She's interested in what we're eating. She's starting to be able to sit on her own. So yeah, we did start Clara around this point as well, but not like, I haven't been very like consistent with it. Like she's had oatmeal a few times with mixed with breast milk. So yeah, just starting slow, like maybe like a little taste of something each day, and then we'll work up more into like baby led weaning probably around 6 months old or so. It's just kind of what we feel comfortable with, giving her some purees and stuff like that. So that's what I'm doing right now. And these are finished boiling, so I'm gonna strain them and then just puree them with our hand mixer. We got one of these hand mixers and I actually really like it. It's so much easier to use than using and clean compared to the food processor that we have. All in these little containers. Got this from Amazon back when Clara was a baby. So got 5 little containers of carrots here for her. Hopefully she'll like them. So this is gonna be the end of this video. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a great big thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.